regarding the appointment or employment of relatives of school superintendents. Is the requester present?
Yes, ma'am. I'm Joy Frank, I'm the general counsel of the Florida Association of District School Superintendents.
Thank you. Staff will present the, Mr. Schaefer will present the draft opinion.
Thank you, Chair. Commissioners, this opinion involves statutory construction. It concerns a recent amendment to a nepotism provision found in the K-20 Education Code. The statute in question is section 1012.23, subsection 2, which until very recently applied just to district school board members, and it prohibited them from appointing or employing relatives who work under their direct supervision. And so the term relative for the purposes of that law will be defined as the term is defined in the nepotism statute in the Code of Ethics. Now, this statute we're talking about, 1012.23, subsection 2, was amended during the 2018 legislative session. The amended language became effective just a few weeks ago, on July 1st. It extends the prohibition of district school superintendents as well, saying they too may not appoint or employ relatives to work under their direct supervision. And it gave the Ethics Commission the authority to investigate statutory violations of that prohibition. And the inquiry here comes from the Association of District School Superintendents. And they point out that the Education Code has a separate statute limiting a school superintendent's involvement in employment and hiring decisions. This separate statute says that when it comes to filling a position, the superintendent has the authority to make recommendations about the hiring, but only the school board has the authority to actually appoint or employ an individual. So given the school superintendents only have the power to make recommendations, the inquiry asks what effect, if any, the amended prohibition will have on it, because this language says it's triggered only if the superintendent actually appoints or employs a relative under their direct supervision, not just if they make recommendations. The first thing to think about when you're engaged in statutory construction is whether the statute is penal in nature. And penal statutes impose penalties. Our ethics laws, including this nepotism provision from the Education Code, are penal statutes. And when you engage in statutory construction about a penal law, you have to strictly or narrowly construe the statute's terms, which means you have to narrowly interpret the law to make sure you don't broaden its scope beyond what the legislature intended. So if you read about a prohibition that only mentions actually appointing or employing relatives, it doesn't mention making recommendations about whether they should be appointed or employed. My recommendation is that you strictly interpret the language of the law. I think that to extend the prohibition to simply making recommendations would be reading words in the statute the legislature did not place there. Now, I have checked the bill analyses for the underlying amendment. There are several analyses prepared. None of them address this particular change about adding superintendents to any great degree. They just say the prohibition will now extend to school superintendents as well, prohibiting them from appointing or employing relatives to work under their direct supervision. But it doesn't clarify what appointing or employing mean, and also doesn't address any recommendations. So the draft before you recommends you find the amendment to this particular statute just prohibits school superintendents from appointing or employing their relatives. I think to more broadly interpret the law would be extending it beyond its plain meaning, and we would have to be inserting a term the legislature did not use. And I will say too, the Code of Ethics has its own nepotism prohibition, which is found in section 112.3135. 3135 specifically states it doesn't apply to district schools, but in its language, it prohibits a public officer from appointing or employing a relative or for advocating for the appointment or employment of a relative. So in other nepotism laws, the legislature has exercised its discretion to have them include making recommendations. For whatever reason, it was tinkering with the language of this particular prohibition in the Education Code, it didn't make that addition. So that's the main focus of the opinion, and I offer it now for your review. I will say the final page of the opinion deals with some other miscellaneous questions that the requester raised about the amendment. I'm happy to discuss those in further detail if you wish, and I'm happy to answer any other questions you might have.
Thank you, Mr. Schaefer. Are there any questions of Mr. Schaefer from the commissioners? Ms. Lesman.
So as I understand it, the amended language of that statute would have no meaning whatsoever since superintendents cannot appoint or hire. And if that is the case, is it reasonable to assume that they would intend to create a law or to amend a law and have it serve the purpose?
I understand your question, Commissioner. In general, laws must be construed and not render language into surplusage or superfluous additions. I think that a situation could arise, though, where school board might delegate hiring authority to a superintendent and that for a particular position. If they choose to do that in their discretion, this particular prohibition might apply in that circumstance. I will say that we have to weigh against all of this. Again, the consideration of our construing these penal statutes, we have to be very strict in how we construe their terms. And I think that, while I understand what you're saying, we would have to actively read in making recommendations then into the statute. And I think that would be going beyond the narrow scope on how we're supposed to look at these laws. Perhaps the legislature will make that correction in the future. I just don't think that that this agency can make it on its own.
Any other questions for Mr. Schaefer? Ms. Frank.
Madam Chair, Commissioners, my name is Joy Frank. I'm the General Counsel for the Florida Association of District School Superintendents. When I first of all, this year, Executive Director and his staff have been outstanding in helping me work through these issues. When I first spoke to them, my main inquiry was the fact that I had received calls from several superintendents asking whether or not they could recommend for appointment or employment a relative that is defined in the statute that would be prohibitive. You've got several situations in school districts where superintendents have relatives who work in the district that have sons and daughters who are principals in the school district or are administrators. They, to my knowledge, work diligently to make sure they do not directly supervise or evaluate any of the relatives listed in the statute. So that was really my initial inquiry. But the more I really looked at the specific language of this statute, it really didn't, it went to appointment or employment, which is not what superintendents do. So maybe perhaps the legislature will amend this in the next session. But for my association's purposes and the superintendent's purposes, the fact that the opinion also, the recommended opinion, also says that it would not trigger the prohibition if a superintendent recommends to the board a relative, then that satisfies me also. So I'm appreciative of the opinion and fine work of your staff and encourage your support.
Thank you, Ms. Rice. Anyone have any questions on this one? Are there any further questions of Mr. Schaefer?
In the circumstance that the board has delegated to the superintendent the power to hire, then the prohibition hypothetically would be in place.
I think it could be, yes.
Okay. Mr. Frank, did you want to comment on that as well?
The way the superintendents and school boards usually work and the way we think about it, I think the statutory scheme also lays out, the school board is the employing entity, it's the legal entity. School superintendents don't employ, they don't contract for employment. They directly supervise, they're responsible for the administration of the district, but they don't directly employ. And they're not a contracting entity. So it would be very rare, I think, for a school board to delegate that authority. The way it works is the school board is responsible for establishing an organizational chart and job descriptions, and then the school superintendent makes recommendations based upon those job descriptions and the vacancies within the
me. Everybody votes for the corporation. And I assume that's the same thing in the school system, that unless it's a sole proprietorship and I'm running the daycare center, I hire the people and they work for me and I earn a paycheck, relatively few people actually work for the people that hire them. They work for corporations that provide them with salary and set benefits. And that's, I mean, I was really surprised when I read this, but I mean, that's, it strikes me as a distinction that I was not aware of, because I am aware of the huge number of relatives of school board members and superintendents who work in the school system. I mean, you know, I know three generations worth of principals in the Dade County school system, and always wondered why nepotism never occurred for that, never applied to that.
Ms. Frank, do you have any further comments? Thank you. Do I have a motion?
Move to adopt the opinion or accept the opinion.
Do I have a second? Thank you. Do I have a second? I have a motion to approve by Mr. McManus, seconded by Commissioner Brady. Are there any further comments on the motion? Seeing none, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign?
Nay.
Or nay? Motion carries with one that did not support.